Do you hate being fat? Do you hate being obese? This is why you're here at the MB Thin Channel, right? 40% of Americans are obese and 70% are fat, but that does not mean that you want to be fat. You don't like the way fat looks, you don't like the way fat feels, you don't like all of the health problems that come with being fat, you don't like all the negatives like your clothes don't fit, and it's harder to get a job, and it's harder to get a date, and you can't be athletic anymore. All that stuff, it drives you nuts. So you come to MB Thin on YouTube, or you come to MBThin.com, and you are ready to lose weight. And I've suggested four exercises to you, like this. In exercise one, you committed to your weight loss. You made a list of heartfelt reasons for losing weight. You made your goal sheet, and you've hung your goal sheet up in one or more prominent places. In exercise two, you documented your current fat self. You photographed yourself, you took some measurements, maybe you took some videos. It's okay to be disgusted with how you look now. Go ahead and document it. In exercise three, you started using a food diary so that you can see exactly how much food you're eating and how many calories are coming in and going out. This step probably tells you exactly why you're overweight or obese. The food diary shows you calories in is probably much greater than calories out. Maybe, with the knowledge you gain from the food diary, you're able to get things under control and start running your own calorie deficit. Or maybe not. So in exercise four, you talked to your doctor, you picked a low-carb diet plan, and you started a low-carb diet. If you're like millions of other people, a low-carb diet has lowered your appetite and greatly reduced your hunger pangs, your cravings, your binge eating, and so on. For many people, they gain control of themselves at exercise four, and they can start using a food diary to run a calorie deficit every day with ease. It works pretty well for me and lots of other people. But what if you're still having problems? What if you just can't stay away from carbs? Or what if you're fine for a week and then on the weekend you eat a whole pizza or you binge a whole container of ice cream? When you do that, you destroy all of your progress for a week or even 2 weeks, and it's incredibly frustrating. What if you're still eating too much, or what if you can't control those binges? If this is where you find yourself, then it's time for exercise five. Your fifth exercise. It's time for you to gain a new level of control over your own body and your own mind by learning about and experimenting with fasting. Yes, fasting. Fasting gives you a way to learn about yourself, a way to gain control of your own body, and it can also have some amazing health benefits. I can tell you the story of how fasting came onto my radar. I reread the book Siddhartha by Hermann Hesse. Yeah, Siddhartha. It was one of those books they made me read in high school, and I did not get it then. But rereading it as an adult, the book is amazing. It actually talks about fasting, too, many times in the book, but here is one of the more revealing passages. Siddhartha is having a conversation with a merchant. The merchant says, "Everyone gives what he has. The soldier gives strength, the merchant goods, the teacher instructions, the farmer rice, the fisherman fish. Very well, and what can you give? What have you learned that you can give?" Siddhartha hears that and he says, "Well, I can think, I can wait, and I can fast." The merchant asks, "Is that all?" And Siddhartha says, "I think that's all." And the merchant says, "And of what use are they? For example, fasting. What good is that?" And Siddhartha's response is really interesting. He says, "It is of great value, sir. If a man has nothing to eat, fasting is the most intelligent thing he can do. If, for instance, Siddhartha had not learned to fast, he would have had to seek some kind of work today, either with you or elsewhere, for hunger would have driven him. But as it is, Siddhartha can wait calmly. He is not impatient. He is not in need. He can ward off hunger for a long time and laugh at it. Therefore, fasting is useful, sir." In other words, what Siddhartha is explaining is that he has control over his own body, his own appetite. He is in control, not his hunger pangs. So how can you learn about fasting and get started with fasting yourself? There are a million books and videos and websites, but here's what I would recommend. I would recommend that you find a documentary by the BBC called Eat, fast, and live longer. Sometimes it's on Netflix. This is where I first found it. You can always find versions of it on YouTube as well, or use a search engine to find it. It's only an hour long, but it lays the whole world of fasting out for you, and it's a great introduction. It also lists off and demonstrates many of the amazing health benefits of fasting by having the host actually try different kinds of fasts. The show documents three different types of fasting. Intermittent fasting, also known as 16-hour fasting, alternate day and 5-2 fasting, and then a 3-day fast. The whole thing is fascinating. You really should watch it. After you watch the video, here are the steps you can take. Step 1, watch the BBC documentary called Eat, Fast, and Live Longer. Second, obviously talk to your doctor, make sure it's okay. Third, try to pull off your first 16-hour fast. Then try to do this multiple times. The first time you try it, it may be impossible for you. You may only last, 8 hours or something, but try and then succeed at doing a full 16-hour fast. Fourth, once you can handle a 16-hour fast, work up to a full 24-hour water-only fast. And then fifth, once you've done a 24-hour fast a couple of times, then try a full 3-day fast as described in the BBC documentary. If you will do this, you will learn so much about yourself and your body and your ability to control your body. Simply do not eat anything and watch what happens. The thing is, once you have a 3-day fast under your belt and have accomplished it 2 or 3 times, you will have a completely different relationship with food. You will realize that you can actually not eat, and it's okay. In fact, it's probably better than eating. And now, when you're on a low-carb diet and you want to break the rules, you'll be able to inject this amazing sentence into your brain. Instead, let's not eat. Let's fast for a day, or even for an hour. You will have this new skill that's incredibly helpful if you're trying to lose weight. Through millions of ads, we've all been fed a huge amount of propaganda about food. All this food advertising is telling us to eat more, constantly, in 1,000 ways every day. It's horrible. But the truth is that we really need to eat less. But no food company makes money when we eat less, so you never hear that message. Fasting is a powerful tool that can really help with eating less. So, for your fifth exercise, give fasting a try. Take these steps. First, watch the BBC documentary called Eat, Fast, and Live Longer. Second, talk to your doctor. Third, try to pull off a 16-hour fast and do that several times. Then try to do a full 24-hour water-only fast. And then, once you can do a day-long fast, try a full 3-day fast as described in the BBC documentary. You will probably find that it's a fantastic experience and that you get a lot out of it. If you'd like to join me on this weight loss adventure, if you'd like to lose weight with me so we can lose weight together, please like and subscribe this video and tell your friends. Bring your friends along for the ride. Tell them about mbthin.com and have them participate in weight loss with you. It can be a lot more fun if you have some friends along for the ride. Thanks for watching today.